Hey guys, Funder here, and I am back for the INORL Racing Network to bring you live flag-to-flag coverage of the INORL Insomniac Elite Series. Tonight, we are here at Talladega. We are under the lights here for the penultimate round of Season 2 of the Insomniac Elite Series. Things are starting to get down on the wire as Seth Cole tries desperately to catch Cosmic Nova in the standings, and we'll have to see if there's anything he can do. He is a little over 40 points behind Nova, about 42 or 43. He had a good run in Alberta, but he needs a good run here as well to keep himself in title contention. Reese Black and Kyle Sanoski are also... Reese Black's also in a race of that 13 car. And then Kyle Sanoski, he could be a title contender, but he's one of the... But he is one of the fourth through ninth drivers who needs to get a good run to get themselves in, because they are a full race, because they are at the moment a full race behind the leader, so they need to get a great run here. Now, aside from the championship, there's not really much of note, so we're just gonna get right down to the track, see our starting lineup, and in one of the biggest upsets in IS history, John Johnston is on the pole for this race. No random draw, just like actual speed got car number 92 on the pole for today's race. On his outside is Maxwell Chan, who is exactly 140 points behind the leader. So actually, Chan's out. That leaves eight drivers. Chan had to have had a perfect day, basically. And he's not gonna pull it off. And as Johnston swept the pole away from him right here. So, all right, row two, Reese Black, one of our title contenders, alongside DJ Curtis. Row three, we have Nick Pericles and Seth Cole, title contender. Row four, we have Alan Cavagnaro, who just came off his first career win, and then Tyler Faber in the 11. And around your top 10, we have Sean Angel and Tristan Wilhoit. Here's the rest of your lineup. Your championship leader, Cosmic Nova, starts a little ways in the back here. He's never really been a super speedway driver, but he's going to make sure he gets a good run here in order to keep his title hopes alive. But anyway, it's time to get those engines fired up, and let's go racing.
Gentlemen, start your engines!
Nice easy, long day. It's gonna be a lot of adjustments. It's gonna be a lot of fun, guys. This is a real race here. We're gonna have a blast tonight. I can't wait to get out there and get going.
John Johnston. It's hard to believe he's on the pole for tonight's race. This puts him in a shootout for next season. Which would probably be his only start of the year, because Johnston won't be racing full time next season. He's going to race in the Slim Jim Series for this same team. Pace car pulls in. 29 laps from now, we will find out who the drivers are that will be contending for the Season 2 IES Championship. John Johnston leads us down with his teammate Reese Black right on his tail. Seth Cole in row three. Nova's a little ways in the back. He'll have to fork his way forward. But we're green. We're rocking to Talladega. And Maxwell Chan got a much better start than the 92. He might be able to clear him as we head into the first turn. Not quite. Johnston still holds on. He didn't get a very good start. Oh, Chan's starting to get a bit of a push from Curtis. But now Johnston has the preferred line. And his teammate behind him, although Reese Black may think more about the championship, or he can get pushed up by Nick Pericles, so now he is going to start pushing the 92. Curtis pushing the 32, down the track. It looks like Chan will take the lead here. So Maxwell Chan goes to the point. And he will be leading at the start of this one. Alan Cavagnaro getting a push from his teammate, Sean Angel. The draft is key here at these types of tracks. Angel's gonna make it four wide, though. 4 wide can work here, but it takes a lot of focus to make sure that nothing bad happens. It can work, but can they make it work? Wow, frame rate dropping big time here. As you can see, big shots here. Oh yeah, that is one beautiful shot right there. Seeing the whole field racing like that. Where's Nova here in the opening stage of this race? He's moving forward. He's probably in the points at this right here. Actually, no, he's in 30. He's in 22nd, and now he's in the points. Yeah, we're gonna see a lot of positions fluctuating here. Chan is still leading. But I got Carl Sander working his way forward. Sander, known to be a super speedway ace, but he hasn't had much. Ironically, he hasn't had much luck on super speedways this season. It really just hasn't been his year for super speedway racing. Well, really, this hasn't been his year at all. Sander, not a title contender. But we'll have to see if he can put himself in the title contention next season. Zachary Fitzwater makes the move for second. Fitzwater, he's gonna be moving to Dodge Motorsports next season. The Australian's gonna be he's got a good ride there of the Dodge Factory team. Gonna be joining Jeffrey Fingai and Reese Black. Oh boy, Finn's getting very close in the back. Oh boy, here we could get a wreck here! We could get a wreck here! There's been a wreck! There has been a crash! Kyle Miller's gone around! And we are ourselves a big pileup! Loads of cars involved! And one of them's Cosmic Nova! Nova's been involved in the first incident of the night! And he is getting bullied right now! Either that or he's getting helped as after all that car might have been getting stuck. William Duncan and Danny Everett have crashed for a second week in a row. Although this time I doubt they collide with each other this time. Maxwell Chan and his good friend Chris Mouvier will be 1-2 here. And actually, Alex Perkel is third, so very interesting podium right now. Maxwell Chan, his good friend Chris Mouvier, and Mouvier's cousin Alex Perkel are in your current podium here as we are under caution for the first time tonight. Here's a look at what happened. Once again, Kyle Miller sticking his nose where he really shouldn't. I mean, it was already very tight, but Kyle Miller makes things worse by sticking his nose in there and it quickly goes wrong, it turns into a 5-wide situation and cause a panic. Gall Relic and Sean Angel getting into each other, and I think that's going to be what triggers this wreck. No, Miller goes down into his teammate, Troy Kang, and then he's going to end up turning Bernard Strauss, and we're going to see a couple cars go around here. There's Nova, he gets turned right there. And you can see it right here, a lot of cars are going to get involved. Duncan slams into Bernard Strauss. Sanford goes around. Mason Powers tries to miss it. Does he do it? I don't know. And he kind of does. Oh, nope, we got rear-ended by Tristan Wilhoit. But then you see this gaggle of cars getting stuck down here on the apron. But Cosmic Nova was involved in this. Your championship leader just barely got clipped and was sent for a loop here. Oh, Valzak! Oh, for a moment I thought David Valzak was going to have an amazing miss, but no, Carver 99 is involved. Valzak won this race last season. Doesn't look like he's going to do it again. But where's Seth Cole and Reese Black? Were they involved? That was one big collision. It seems like they, for the most part, they missed it, but Reese Black might have had a slight collision. Did they? No! Seth Cole and Reese Black missed it completely! Patience is a virtue, and Cole and Black proved that. They stepped on the brakes and waited for everything to die down. And those two missed the wreck without a scratch, so Seth Cole and Reese Black will probably be fighting Nova for the championship when we head to Fontana. Or at least that's what it looks like. So great driving by those two, but let's get back to live. We're going back to green light. We're 9 of 29. There are only 28 cars left in this race. 24 on the lead lap. Maxwell Chan is your leader. Second is Chris Luvier. Third is Alex Perkel. Fourth is Jump Day Cook. Fifth is going to be Marcus Bruno. Sixth is Sean Angel. Seventh is Ryan Acosta. Eighth is Carl Sander. Ninth is Zachary Fitzwater. Tenth is Norman Miller. 11th is Chris Washer. 12th is Reese Black. 13th is Seth Cole. 14th is DJ Curtis. 15th is Troy Kang. 16th is James Silverfox. 17th is Gull Redlick. 18th is Dylan Young. 19th is James Shelley. And Eric and Rage rounds out your top 20. Maxwell Chan, so Chan, Luvier, and Perkel all lead right now. Chan might not win the championship, but he is still looking to have himself a great run out here, and he's doing it so far. But there's four lap cars on an inside line that could play with here, could play the results here, especially that 32A of Kyle Miller, as he has been known to cause trouble this season. Luckily, we don't believe he's going to be back on the Baby Tribe 5000 next season. Miller might not be back next season. And that's probably going to be a relief for a majority of the field. Maybe even some of Miller's teammates, as he has not been nice to teammates either. Chan breaks away with the help of the lap car, so the lap car is actually a good thing for the Californian. He's going to break away here. Luvier's gone to the outside. And he's going to get past the lap traffic as well. And Perkel now moves into third. So they're still sweeping the podium. Luvier now trying to get a slingshot on the 32 of Chan. And oh wow, he is gaining ground very quickly. Chan not wanting to move over for his teammate. But Luvier is going to find a way. He shoves him out of the way and makes the move. Things are getting very tight. Sander and Collins have made contact. Sander's touching the apron. Those two are almost wrecking right there. Hopefully they won't. But it's getting uncomfortably close. Oh, Collins and Angel make contact. That's two Canadians right there. We don't know where Kyle Collins is going next season. Oh, Bruno almost turns to five. This is getting very scary right now. Reese Black's naturally trying to get Frutus as quickly as he can. And he is trying to get through. Seems he's gotten away from the worst of it, and so has Seth Cole. Here we go, things starting to settle out here. Yeah, Reese Black and Seth Cole kind of need to work together. Or just like, wow, the top three are working together. Luvier, Perkel, and Chan, they're all in a single file line at the moment. I have a feeling Luvier's loving this. The top three are tandeming. And they are Chris Luvier, his cousin Alex Perkel, and his good friend Maxwell Chan in the 32. And also, don't forget, if Alex Perkel gets the top 10, kids eat free. Oh boy, I don't think Golden Corral wants to make it that kids can eat free 2 weeks in a row. Because Perkel got top 10 last week in Alberta. And Chan, he steps out. He's gonna try and make his move back to the front. He wants to get the lap leader bonus, which is handed out for leading the most laps. Seth Cole starting to make his way towards the front. He's got his teammate DJ Curtis behind him. Curtis probably won't be back at S3 next season. Seth Cole is all but confirmed, though. Reese Black making his way forward. Black will be back with that team, and then behind him is Bowman Miller, who's retiring. Miller could be in the title hunt, though. But this is exactly what Seth Cole needed. If he gets a good enough finish, he could actually take the championship lead. Seth Cole could do that. I don't think Reese Black could at this point, though. I don't think he can get the lap leader bonus at this point. But it would take the lap leader It would take the lap leader bonus for him to be able to take the championship lead. He would have to get the lap leader bonus and then win. And if that doesn't look like it's in the and the lap and the lap leader bonus doesn't appear, it's in the cards for him. But a win could happen here as he is going to take the lead from Maxwell Chan. And Ryan Acosta making his move up here. Acosta was recently re-signed by Young Motorsports. So, Acosta, he's going to return to that team. Ian Dutta, however, is not. Ian Dutta will not be returning to Young Motorsports, but Ryan Acosta, the former Sony IndyCar Series regular, now an IAS driver, an IAS race winner, two-time race winner, and he's going to be with that team next season. Some good equipment for that 12 team. Marcus Bruno up here as well. He's going to try and make it four wide here. He's going to pull that off. Hopefully nothing goes wrong here. He's going to get a push from Carl Sanner. The Minnesota native Sanner. Oh, Sanner's looking. Don't do that. Oh, boy. Curtis and Acosta getting close to each other. They're making contact. They have made contact. They are rubbing against each other. Not something you want to do at over 220 miles an hour. As Reese Black, oh, Black almost got turned by his teammate. Oh, wreck! Oh, we got ourselves a big crash! Seth Cole and Reese Black are both involved. Oh, a massive pileup has occurred here on lap 14. No, 16, I mean. A big crash has transpired. Chris Louvier, his day is done. His night's over. Seth Cole is out, Reese Black is out, Norman Miller. Oh, wow. So, things just went wrong for Cole and Black, and their title hopes aren't looking so bright anymore. Zachary Fitzwater leads the race right now with Marcus Bruno in second and Carl Sanner in third. We're going to go back and take a look at what happened there. A big crash here on lap number 16. Well, let's take a look here. Was it Miller? Was it something else? Ooh, there's a little bit of contact there, but I don't think it was him. And no, it was not. It was Sean Angel and Jukte Cook, two Canadians getting together there. So let's move down here, see what happened with these guys. And they're going four wide. It looks like Sean Angel just got too close to Jukte Cook, and the two Canadians collide, go up the track, take out Chris Lavier. Seth Cole barely gets touched, and that's going to go horribly wrong for him, as they basically explode and get sent flying. Several cars go for rolls. Wow, Reese Black and Chris Lavier basically tandem flipping there. Not a very serious crash injury-wise, but oh boy, it is certainly a big one. Now, we've already gotten word that everyone's got to have their cars under their own power. It's not a serious incident, but it is a big one. Wow! That's not something you see every day. Four cars went over there. Nova and Louvier and Miller tandem rolling. They should be on the USA. Oh my god, they should be on the USA gymnastics team. Even though Norman Miller is 68 years old. So, big crash. And Seth Cole and Reese Black are going to have some work to do when they head to Fontana. Well, let's get back to live. We're going back to green lap for 20 of 29. There's going to be 10 laps to go. 22 cars are left in this race, 18 of which are on the lead lap. Zachary Fitzwater is your leader. Second is Marcus Bruno. Third is Carl Sanner. Fourth is DJ Curtis. Fifth is Alex Perkle. Sixth is Maxwell Chan. Seventh is Gaul Redlick. Eighth is John Johnston. Ninth is Felix Fyodor. Tenth is James Shelley. 11th is Chris Washer. 12th is Eric Enrage. 13th is Mason Powers. 14th is Connor Atwood. 15th is James Silverfox. 16th is Dylan Young. 17th is Troy King, 18th is Ryan Acosta, and then 19th is Alex Hawkins, and Allie Nelson rounds at the top 20. So a very chaotic round of Talladega here. And the championship between the top three is not going to budge. None of the title contenders are going to score points in this race. Meaning this is a big opportunity for other drivers to get themselves into this fight. Ottawa won't. Well, Kyle Sanoski won't be one of them. Won't be one of them. His title hopes are over. Are there any mathematical contenders who are actually still in this race? I mean, like, with a good shot. Chan, he's really the only one, but he's not in contention anymore. I believe Hawkins is out. Shelley's out. Dylan Young's the only one left, and he's got some heavy damage on that car, so it's probably down to just those three. Although we do have to put some thought into Rookie of the Year. Zachary Fitzwater is trying to catch Kyle Collins, the Rookie of the Year championship. Fitzwater's leading this race right now. Kyle Collins, he's a lap down though. So Rookie of the Year is going to be very close, it looks like. And Fitzwater, he hasn't exactly got this in the bag. Oh, yep, he's getting passed by Marcus Bruno, who is looking for his first IS win. He almost won Indy, couldn't pull it off, though. Alex Pirkel getting a push from Redlick. Both those two looking for their first win. Pirkel almost won this race last season, I think, but didn't quite pull it off. Like Bruno's gonna lead this lap. The Brazilian trying to become the first Brazilian to win an IES race. Speaking of which, damn Brazilian, I do remember what happened here last season. Ian Dutta got involved in a massive crash of Charles Sanford. Those two surprisingly, like those two luckily survived, but were both out. Neither of them raced Fontana. Interestingly enough, both of them were taken out in the first wreck. Dutta actually wound up 42nd, but hey, at least they're not dead. I think they just kind of want to leave this place because they really don't want to be around here after what happened at the track last season. Oh, Redlick makes it four wide for the lead. Honestly, not surprised that he would make that move. But oh, we got contact, and Fitzwater's gone for a spin. Marcus Bruno and Alex Pirkel are collected. Oh, Fitzwater gets clipped by Kyle Miller. That's enough to kill that car. Bruno, he's collected. Kyle Miller, his night is over. Who's leading this race? And that would be Carl Sanner, who does have damage, though. I think. Looks like it. Yeah, there's damage on the free. So things, there's damage on the 88 of Curtis as well. But Sanner will lead when we get down to the stripe here. I think we're not going to have many laps to go at all. I think we're only have like a one or two lap shootout here. Let's go and take a look at what happened. Well, here's a look. Gall Redlick makes it four wide. An inexperience ends up causing an issue as Pirkel goes down into Carl Sanner. They go up the track into Zachary Fitzwater. They collide. Bruno gets spun around as well. Those three go up into the wall. And then Zachary Fitzwater is going to get flipped by Kyle Miller, and that's enough to send that car, to make that car start smoking. Something goes wrong internally, and that's his day. That is his night over. Marcus Bruno, he continues on. I think... Oh, it looks like karma may have struck the 27 team. Oh, wow, he saved it. He got hit. Sanner shot down the track in the 27, sent him sideways, and Redlick saved it. Great driving by the German to keep himself on the road. So, yeah, great move for him. All right, so let's get back to green for the final restart of the day. We're going back to green here in lap 20 out of 29. We're going to have a two-lap shootout. Jarvis out of race saw last incident are Zachary Fitzwater and Kyle Miller. 20 cars left in the race, so we know who's going to be scoring. Carl Sanner is the leader with some damage. DJ Curtis is second, also of damage. Felix Fedor is third, no damage on our car. Fourth is John Johnston. Fifth is James Shelley. Sixth is Maxwell Chan. Seventh is Gall Redlick. Eighth, Kyle Collins. Eighth is Chris Washer. Ninth is Eric Enrage. And tenth is Mason Power. Ian Masterson Racing almost won this race last season with Alex Perkel, so perhaps Powers could get himself in there. I don't believe that car has any damage, so yeah. So Mason Powers is going to try and get himself possibly a win. We do believe Ian Masterson Racing is interested in signing him for the full season in the next season, because Ian Masterson Racing will finally go full-time in the IS. They've signed Lewis Duran, a Slim Jim Series regular, and they're planning on signing Mason Powers as well, but Powers has not given confirmation that he wants to return to the team. But anyway, let's get back to the race now. The top two have damage. They're probably not going to win this race, but it's certainly going to make for an interesting situation here when that green flag waves. Fifth place, James Shelley, also has damage. We're green. Sander got a great restart. So we got a great restart, but he's probably going to get caught here. There is some heavy left side damage on that free car, but he's going to do whatever it takes. I think he's going to take advantage of DJ Curtis holding up the 39. And John Johnston is here as well. Johnston looking to pull off a massive upset here and win his first IS victory here. He's going to make a move on Theodore. Oh, but Curtis moved down. Curtis moved down and is going to block Johnston. And Theodore is going to go to the outside of car number 88. Curtis being a big issue, though, as Sander is loving this. Sander going to try. Oh, but Maxwell Chan's made a move. Chan is trying to make a move stick here. And Sander, oh boy, he's going to be getting very nervous here as the white flag waves. Can a damaged car win at Dega? Sander's been looking for a win this entire season. Can he pull it off? He's going to need a little bit of luck. Chan is coming! Chan is coming very quickly! I think Chan's gonna get this! He's got a big burst of speed coming down the backstretch! And he is gonna blast right by the free! And Sander, there's nothing you can do about it! That car is not gonna be strong enough to hold on! The flyby camera, you're gonna see it right here! Chan comes up the final corner! And while he won't be a title contender, he's still going to get himself a big victory here. Yes, Maxwell Chan will win here at Talladega. Maxwell Chan, all he needed to do was get the pole and he would still be a title contender. Unfortunately, not going to be a title contender. Going to come up 5 points short of that, but 5 or 10, but I don't think he cares. Chan, now a two-time winner in the IES. Congratulations to him. Carl Sander almost won the race of a damaged car, but I think he'll take a second. Although he'll probably still not be happy. Third is going to be James Shelley. Fourth is John Johnston. Best career finish for him, I believe. Fifth is Felix Theodore. Sixth is DJ Curtis. Seventh is Chris Washer. Eighth is Ryan Acosta. Ninth is Mason Powers. And Marcus Bruno rounds out the top 10. So, you can see the cars come down pit road here, and they're going to be packing up here at Talladega. Where are they going next week? Why? To Fontana, California, to the Fontana Speedway, of course. It's time to end this. Next time you see us on the INORL Racing Network, it'll be for the last time in the INORL Racing Network. It's going to be time for the final INORL race. Here for the season 2 finale of the Insomniac Elite Series. I've been of the INORL for a long time, and it's gonna be very sad to see that the INORL come to an end. So next time it's going to be the final. So next time, it's time for the final INORL race and the final race of Season 2 of the Insomniac Elite Series. The stage is set, and you'll be seeing your title contenders right here down at the end. I'm pretty sure, though, that Kozak Nova and Seth Cole and Reese Black will be fighting for your championship. But just to check, we'll be seeing here right at the end. If you're more than 70 points behind the leader, you're out of mathematical contention. But here we go. It's time to end this. Stage is set. That is it for tonight. Be sure to stick around next week when we finish up the INORL Insomniac Elite Series Season 2 at Fontana Speedway, and say goodbye to the INORL. Here comes the results and standings. You've been watching a production of the INORL Racing Network, Racing Uncontained. I'm signing off, and I'll see you next time.